Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. And as you can see, my Kubota has changed. There's a front loader now attached to it. The B2 series in Europe, you can add the LA424 front loader to it. When I ordered the tractor, I didn't want to do that because I had the idea to put in the front side mounting of a transport box. You can see a video of that. But the amount of digging that I need to do is now much larger than I initially expected it to be. I have some pumps that I want to change. Also some other parts that I want to change as well, some landscaping. So I thought, yeah, let's go for it. Let's install a front loader. I asked my dealer and asked him if it's possible to have the combination, because of course, as you might know, I also have the front hitch, the Zuidberg front hitch, and it was possible to have them both in at the same time. Because of the front hitch mounting at the frame, it is not possible to put directly the front grille on. So I asked my dealer to give me the front grille as a separate part, and I need to see if it's possible still to mount it. I'm not sure, because it has to be adapted quite a lot, and also have to see if it's possible even to have space around there to mount it. But that's something that I will have a look at, to see if it's still possible to mount this grill. What I really like is this quick connect system, that you can easily take off the front part, because I have some ideas of creating some new implements that I need to have around here, which you cannot even buy. So but that's something for future. So let me demonstrate you now the combination of the front loader as well as the front hitch. Here you see the hydraulic valves. In this position the front loader is connected. Switching it to the front hitch. So you can see, I can use both. In the position that they are now are, the front hitch and the loader can never hit each other. But when the front hitch is increased in height, so when you take it up, much higher than now, and you put the loader in a very low position, so even lower than it is right now, so below ground level, then there is a slight possibility that those two can hit. But this cannot occur when the front hitch is in this position, but since after a while maybe I become less cautious, and as a result it might happen. So what I will do is I will add a U-shaped beam over the hydraulic pipes to protect them for that. This U-shaped beam I don't have yet. I will order it and I will show you when I mount it in another video. The loader comes with a bucket level indicator, which by itself of course is a nice thing. And as you can see, when the bucket level indicator is in the bend, then the bucket is level. But when I now put the loader up, the bucket level indicator does not move, but clearly it's not level anymore. So the bucket level indicator with this construction will only work at the level of the tractor. Nevertheless, it's still a nice feature when you want to do some work at plane level of the tractor. The bucket level indicator is a nice feature, but the rod is bent. I don't know why it is bent. I'm not sure if it is intended to be bent. Maybe it's because of the transport, but I want to make it straight again because now it's coming quite close to the hood. And what I don't want is that I scratch the hood with this rod trying to mount the front loader. What I also don't like is that the rod is quite sharp. It can be that it will, during mounting or during work, it can scratch against the hood or the loader. So what I will do is I will put on a plastic cap like this. You can buy them in almost every hardware store. And by mounting that, it will prevent that the rod will scratch against the paint of the hood or the loader. I straightened the bend, so now the rod is straight. Also put some tape underneath the black cap so it will stick properly. And I also put some red tape under here. So whenever the red is now popping up through the hole, I immediately see that it's level. So I'm very happy with it. I really like to start doing some digging work. I don't have any experience with a front loader with a bucket, so it will be quite some learning experience for me in the beginning. I can use a transport box at the back for the backside ballast weight. It's quite large and I can even put on some extra weight if I would like to increase that the ballast on the back. But I'm also thinking about making it a little bit more compact because it becomes quite large then. For maneuverability, I think it would be better. We'll see. So I'm really looking forward to do some digging with the front loader, reshaping the ponds, but also creating some other implements that I can attach to the front loader to do the landscaping here in the Low Countries.